My dear friend, welcome to Rebuild My Church Again Bishop channel. Thanks for subscribing this channel and hearing two videos yesterday and sending them to your good friends. Today, let us reflect on something that everyone is experiencing, and that is problems in life. Some people think that a life without a problem is a good life. But is it so? It is not so. There is no one in this world without any problem. You can take the richest man and the poorest man, both are having enough and more problems. You take a holiest man, you take the worst sinner, both are having lot of problems. Every person has lot of problems, and therefore problems are inevitable in life. Even a small child who is just born begins its life by crying because there is a problem of not getting the breath, adjusting to the world situation outside the womb. So man begins his life with a problem. So there are three kinds of problems, or three categories of problems we can speak about. One is a big problem and a small problem. Some may have a big, others may have small. So it depends. The other category is some problems are known to others, whereas some problems are unknown to others. And the third category will be, in the problem you suffer alone, or the other category, there are other people who suffer along with you. So no matter what type of the problem, what size the problem has, or what color the problem has, there is a problem. And how to deal with it? This is the first thing that we need to know. There are some people who try to run away from the problem, or others who try to delay in dealing with the problem. Both these ways are not any solution. It is not going to help a man in any way. Problems are not like a great Bordeaux wines. They don't improve with age. If we delay the problem, don't think the problem will become small or it will get resolved by itself. Often it is not the case. Similarly, if you don't deal with the reality, the reality of the problem, then what will happen? The reality will deal with you. So we have to make a choice, either to deal with it or run away from it. The best option is always to deal with the problem, because it is not a big deal. So, my dear friend, first thing what we need to be is to be realistic. Accept that there is a problem. Accept that there is a problem. And then look at that problem as an opportunity. It is an opportunity for what? For many things. For many things. For example, when we have a problem, one thing what we need to understand is problems are always there, and a good life is achieved only through constant readjustments. So when there is a problem, probably it is an opportunity for us to readjust our stand, to readjust our actions, to readjust the steps that we have taken. We have to make some changes. So one way of dealing with the problem is to look at it in a realistic manner and see what changes I should make, either in my own position or in the position of others, in what way we can readjust. That is one of the best means of solving the problem. Another realization that we must have is world is getting complicated day by day. So when we started doing something, the situation was something, but later the situation changes. So we cannot stick on to the things that we had in the beginning. As the world is getting complicated, remember, less important is your starting point. No, don't stick to the starting point. There are some people who are adamant. No, I began like this. Now I'm not going to change. No, you have to change because the situation has changed. The world has become more complicated. And therefore, what is required is to practice the art of correction. Practice the art of correction. How to do that? By revising things that are not quite working. If it doesn't work, then we have to revise those things. And how to do it? We have to do it quickly and without feeling guilty. There is no problem in changing the decision. Then you don't need to feel guilty about it because the situation is warranting such an intervention. So practice the art of correction by revising things that are not quite working swiftly, quickly, and that too without feeling guilty. That is the prudent thing that we can do. And once we are ready for this, the next what we need to do is to trust in the Lord. Because God sees our problems from above. And as a result, God has a comprehensive idea of what we are undergoing. That is why in the book of Psalms, chapter 46, verses 1 and 2 says, God is our refuge and strength, always ready to help in times of trouble. So have recourse to God. Take refuge in God. Pray to God. He will enlighten you as to what you should do. Verse 2 says, therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, etc. No matter what happens, even if it is no earth-shaking problem, we need not worry because God is our refuge and our strength. And Jesus has repeated or re-echoed the same thing in John 14, verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. So this is what the assurance, what the Lord is giving to us. So when we have problems, what we need to do is immediately turn to God and ask for help. So my dear friend, that's all for today. Before I give you my apostolic blessing, let me make a request to you. Please forward this talk to others also for their benefit. Please listen to one more talk if possible. It will bring more blessings on you, on your family, on your children, and on your work. Now, please make an intention in your heart. Make a small prayer, which is more urgent. Okay? So here we go. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wish you a good day. Yours in the mission of the church, Bishop Franco Mulakil.